Okay, so as such, any topic from your side that I need to discuss again? Otherwise, I will start with a new one.
I'm okay.
Okay, let me start with a new topic. In case of any problem will be there with the previous topic, I will go with that. So, what exactly we are going to start from today? It's a PL/SQL. Till now, we are just familiar with the SQL commands and all. SQL command means we are familiar with how to apply the select statement, how to apply the joins, how to apply the subqueries, how to apply the constraint. So these are the basic stuff that we are comfortable with. Now, what exactly we need to start with? We need to start with the PL/SQL. Let me open with the notepad. I'm just going to write ed. ED stands for edit, and I'm going to create a file over here in this particular location. And this is the location of the file. I'm just going to create the file on the desktop itself. So ed pl1.sql. So I'm just going to create a file called pl1.sql. This is the comment line in Oracle. This is the comment line in Oracle. Now I'm going to start with the PL/SQL. PL stands for programming language by the use of SQL. Remember what exactly the PL/SQL is? It's a kind of block structured programming language. It's a kind of block structured programming language. Remember, in SQL, we can't do the programming. In SQL, we can't do the programming. Even though the SQL is the language, but we can't do the programming with the SQL because SQL is non-procedural language. Non-procedural language means what? No jumping, no looping, no branching. Jumping means go to, looping, for loop, while loop. Branching means if else. We don't have. Because in the SQL, we don't have the jumping, looping, and branching. These things are not available over there. We don't have the loop. We don't have the if statement. That's why we can't write the program with the SQL. For that purpose, what exactly we are having? We are having the PL/SQL. So PL/SQL is what? It's a kind of block structured programming language. Now, when we are talking about the block structured programming language, these are the different blocks in the PL/SQL. Like we are having the declare block. We are having the declare block. Declare block is used to declare the variable. To declare the variable, we are having the declare block. Next, we are having the begin. Next, we are having the exception block. And finally, we are having the end block. Declare, begin, exception, end. Declare is to declare the variables. Begin is the start of your program. Exception to handle the exceptions. If I want to handle the exceptions or runtime error, we will go for the exception handling block. And end is the last of the program. So we are having the different blocks over there. We are having declare block, begin block, exception block, and end block. Now, I'm just going to write the first program. And before that, how to write the PL/SQL code? PL/SQL code. Number one, we can write the PL/SQL code directly in the SQL environment. Like here, we can start the PL/SQL code. Here, we can start with the PL/SQL code like declare. I'm going to declare the variable name is of type varchar2 of 20 colon equal to. Suppose I'm going to give the name Santosh. This is how we can declare the variable in PL/SQL. To declare the variable, we need to use colon equal to. Now, what I need to do, I'm just writing begin. Now, what I need to do, I need to display the variables. How we can display this? To display in PL/SQL, we can use dbms underscore output dot put underscore line. I need to display nm. And finally, I need to end this program. And in the last, we need to use the slash. And you will get the output. This is how you can start your PL/SQL program. So what I need to do? I'm just going to write declare. This is the Oracle environment. Directly you are going to start your program. I'm just going to write declare nm is of type varchar 2 of 20 colon equal to. I'm going to give the values for this Santosh and begin. It's the start of the program. Now I'm going to write dbms underscore output dot put underscore line. What I need to display nm, and finally I'm going to write and. In the last I need to give slash. If I'm not going to give the slash, it will wait for that. So at last we need to use the slash. I'm getting PL/SQL procedure successfully completed, but we are not getting the output. To get the output in the PL/SQL, this is the first thing that we need to do. Set server output on. This is the first thing that we need to do. And after this, I'm going to run the program. Yeah, we are getting the output, Santosh. So to get the output, this is the first line we need to write. Set server output on. Now, after this, if I'm going to write the program, I will get the output, Santosh, over there. So this is the process. This is how we can write the PL/SQL program. We need to declare the variable. Then we have to write the begin is the block. Then to display, we need to use dbms underscore output dot put underscore line. Dbms underscore output is the name of the package. And dot put underscore line is the name of the function. So this is this line we need to write to display. And finally, I'm going to use and at last, I'm going to use slash. But before anything, we just need to write set server output on. So this is the first line that you need to write. So this is the first way to write the program. But normally we are not going to follow this approach. Like writing the PL/SQL program in the SQL environment, it's a bad practice. Normally we don't prefer this. So what I will do, I will just open the notepad. So this is the first step that you can do. But normally I'm not going to give you the suggestions for this. And one important thing that we need to remember, the first thing that we need to do, what we need to write, set server output on. Set server output on. This is the first thing that we need to write. But normally I'm not going to prescribe, I'm not going to suggest you to go for this approach. So what will be the another approach? This is the SQL environment. I will just open ed. Suppose e drive is there. I'm just going to give /a.sql. So when I will write the ed, it will open the notepad. And I'm going to create a file in the e drive by the name of a.sql. Now, here I need to write the program. I will write the code over here. I will write this code over here. And finally close this. Save the file and exit. Save file and exit. Now, in this SQL environment, what we need to do, at the rate of /e:// the name of the file. And this program will get executed. So I'm just going to follow this approach. Better open the notepad or open the any editor. And in that particular editor, write the code, save the file and exit. And finally, at the rate, name of the file to execute the program. So I'm just going to follow this approach. So first thing, what I need to do, ed. Because I don't have the e drive, so I'm writing /c:// user Santosh desktop pl1.sql. So this is the file, and I'm going to write my first program over there. So I'm writing first PLSQL program. How to write the PLSQL program? This is how we can do this. I'm writing declare NMEJ type var cat 2 of 20 colon equal to, I'm going to give like Santosh. And finally begin. And I need to display, I'm writing DBMS underscore output dot put underscore line. What I need to display, NM and slash. Now my program is ready. Now what I need to do, file, save, file, exit. Now run the program at the rate file name. Yeah, it's working. It's working. So this is the approach that we need to follow. So either we can write the PLSQL program over there directly, and directly you can execute this, but we are not going to follow this rule. What I will do, what we will do exactly, we will open the notepad, we will open the any editor, give the path of the files and all, and we just need to write the program, and this is how we can run the PLSQL program. It's clear how to start the PLSQL program. What we need to do, first of all, I'm just going to write ed, the name of the file. It will open the notepad, and here we need to write the program. So I'm just going to write the second program in the PLSQL. Second program in PLSQL. So now we are familiar with how to declare the variables and how to display the values and all. Now what I'm looking for, like this was the first program, declare NM begin DBMS underscore output dot put line to display. Finally, we are using like this one, like this. Now what I'm looking for, I'm looking for the user input. I'm looking for user input. So in the place of Santosh, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to use ampersand micro NM. So it will ask me for the input, and this it will display the values. And I'm just going to write like the name is concatenation with NM. I'm writing the name is concatenated with NM. Run this at the rate. Yeah. Enter value for NM. I'm just going to give the value like Kapil, and I'm getting the name is Kapil. Once again, I need to execute this. I'm writing pl2.sql. Enter the value for name. Suppose I'm going to give Akash, and we are getting the name is Akash. So this is how we can do the PLSQL program. What we need to do, always we need to start with the ed, write the program, and run the program. That's it. So this is the second program. So now we are familiar with how to declare the variable, how to go for the user input, how to display. At last, what we need to do, slash. And finally, to run the program, what we need to do, at the rate file. So now the next program I'm going to start with, pl3.sql. Now the third program, like suppose I'm looking for the how to apply the if statement, how to apply the for loop, how to apply the while, how to apply the case. So these things we need to familiar with. I'm just using NEJ type number of 4. I'm writing ampersand N. It's going for the user input. Now I am writing if N greater than 100, then. Always with the if we need to apply the then. I am writing what I need to display. I need to display N greater than 100. I am using else. I am writing DBMS underscore output.putLine, output.putLine, and I'm using n less than 100. And finally, I'm going to use endif. This is how we can apply the if statement. At last, we need to use the endif. With if, we always need to apply then. Else is not required, even we can ignore this. But if it's required, we can go for this, like this. So this is the if statement. Now, we can also apply the if statement like this. I'm going to use if n less than 100. If n less than 100, I'm going to write n less than 100. Now I'm using else if n greater than 100 and n less than 200. Then what I need to do, I'm writing dbms underscore putLine n less than 200. Again, I'm going to use else. So this is how you can put the multiple condition. I'm writing n greater than 200. So this is how we can do this. Remember, in the else if, we are not going to use else if like this. It's not required. This is a part of the syntax. Run this. At the rate pl3.sql, enter value for n 789, and we are getting the output. It's clear how to use the if statement. Yes, please. As such, any problem?
No, I don't.
Okay.
How about the last else if? What did we get in terms of printf? It's less than 100, greater than 100, too. So we say less than 200.
See, if the value of n will be more than 100 and the value of n is less than 200, then you will get the message n less than 200.
And what did we get? Did we get n less than 200? I didn't see that. So you were SQL here.
Suppose I'm going to give 123. See what message we are getting.
Okay, n less than. Okay. And we have n greater than 100, right? There.
Okay. Basically, what I'm trying to say, I'm just trying to say that this is the if statement we are using.
Yep.
Yeah, this is the if statement we are using. This is the syntax that we need to follow. Now, we are having the for loop, like for I in 1.5 loop. This is how we can apply the for loop. For I in 1.5 means the initial value will be 1. The last value will be 5, and I'm going to display this. I'm writing, going to display this I, and finally I'm going to use end loop. This is the for loop we are having, for I in 1.5, and finally I'm going to display this, and finally I'm going to use the end loop. Remember, whatever the variables we are going to use with the for loop, like for I, we don't need to declare this variable. We don't need to declare this variable over here, that we need to remember. So this is the for loop we are having. If I want to display the for loop in reverse order, we can use for I in reverse. So this is how we can apply the reverse for loop. Like the initial value will be 5, after that 4, 3, 2, 1. So this is how we can apply the for loop. See what we are getting. We are getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then we are getting 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So this is how we can apply the for loop. This is how we can apply the for loop. This is how we can apply the if statement. We are having the while loop also there. Like I'm going to use while c less than equal to 5 loop, and I'm going to use DBMS underscore output dot put line. What I need to do, C, and I'm using C colon equal to C plus 1. And this C we need to declare over there. I'm going to declare this. C is of type number of 3, colon equal to 0. So this is the initial value I'm going to give. This is how we can apply the while loop. See, we are getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is how we are getting the value from the while loop. So this is a part of the syntax that we need to remember, how to apply the while loop, how to apply the for loop. Other than the while loop, other loop is also there that we are having loop and loop. We are having the loop and we are having the and loop. Remember, when we are going to use the loop and loop, we must use to exit condition. Exit when C is equal to 10. I'm just going to write exit when C is equal to 10. Remember, if I'm going to use exit when C is equal to 10, the loop will get exit when the value of C will be 10. So we are having the loop and loop also. And when we are going to use the loop and loop, there must be some exit condition. This exit condition is required. If we don't have the exit condition, then this loop will be the never-ending loop. We are getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. At the 10, it's going to terminate. So this is how we can apply the if statement. This is how we can apply the for loop. This is how we can apply the while loop. And this is how we can apply the loop and loop. So these are the main fundamental construct for the programming and all. And one important thing is there, like we are having the case statement. We are having the case statement also over there. I'm going to use case n. I'm using case n. I'm using when 100, then I need to display dbms underscore output output line n is equal to 100. I'm writing case. I'm giving when 200, then I'm writing n is equal to 200, n is equal to 200, else I'm going to write n not equals to 200 or 100. I'm just going to give this message over there. Run this. I'm just going to give 100. Oh, sorry. We are having some syntax problem over there. We need to use end case. It's not the end loop. 100, 200. Yeah, we are getting n is equal to 200. So this is how we can apply the case statement also. This is how we can apply the case statement. We can also use the case statement like this, case. And I'm just going to remove the variable from here. Now I'm writing when n greater than 100, then or when n less than 100, then what I need to display n less than 100. I'm writing when n greater than 100 and n less than 200, then we can use n less than 200. Else I'm going to write n greater than 200, greater than equal to 200. So this is how we can apply the case. Either we can declare the variable over there and then we can put equal to condition. Otherwise, if I want to put greater than, less than and all, then this is how we can apply this. Run this at the rate. I'm going to give 230. We are getting the message like 230 and greater than 200, greater than equal to 200. So these are the programming fundamentals, like how to apply the if statement, how to apply the case and case, how to apply the for loop, how to apply the while statement, and how to apply the loop and loop. In PL/SQL, the entire PL/SQL, always we need to follow all these things. So these are the basic fundamentals. Always we need to remember the syntax, how we need to start with. If I'm going to apply the if statement, there must be then and there must be end if. If we are going to apply the case, there must be end case. If I'm going to apply the for loop, in the last we need to use the end loop. If I need to apply the for loop in reverse order, I will go for the for I in reverse. This is how we can apply the while loop. And this is how we can apply the loop end loop. It's clear because you people are having the background of the Java and all. So now you are you people are very much familiar with how to apply the if statement, how to use the switch case, for loop, while. So you people are familiar with this. So I think I don't need to worry about this. So it's fine.
Yeah, picking up the syntax. Yeah, I think it's pretty obvious.
Yeah, it's basically only again, my objective is also just to make you familiar with the syntax. Because once you get the familiar with the syntax, then you can apply with this in program. Okay. Now I'm going to run with the start with the next program over there. It's PL4, and this program is about how to use select statement in PLSQL. Remember, in PLSQL, select statement can't return more than one row. In PLSQL, select statement can't return more than one row. That we need to remember. And this is the syntax that we need to remember. Select column name into variable name from table name where condition. The important thing is select column name like select ename. We need to use the keyword into over there, into variable name from table name where condition. Always we need to remember, like in PLSQL, select statement can't return more than one row. So right now we are not able to run select star from emp. We can't do that. So always we need to put some where condition. So how we can do this? I'm just writing declare. I'm using enemies of type varchar2 of 20. Begin. I'm just using declare enemies of type varchar2 of 20. Begin. Now I'm going to run select ename into nm. So I'm going to select the ename and going to put the ename into the nm. So I'm writing select ename into nm from emp. Select ename into nm from emp, and we need to put the where condition. So I'm going to give like where imply number is equal to 7788. So for imply number 7788, whatever the value will be there, whatever the name will be there, the name will get stored into the nm. Now what I need to do, I need to display the nm. So I'm going to write this dbms underscore output dot put line. What I need to display, I need to display nm. I'm going to display the nm. And finally, I'm going to end the program. This is how we can apply the select statement in PLSQL. Select enm into nm. Nm is what? It's a variable. So you are going to store the value in this particular variable. And finally, we need to display these values. I'm going to display this. Run this. We don't have the EMP table. We are getting the message table of view does not exist. So I'm just going to connect with another user. Run the program. Oh, I'm getting the message. No data found. Good. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to execute some demo BLD file over there. Yeah, this file is there, demo BLD.sql. I'm just going to execute this file to get the EMP table. Demo BLD.sql. Now I'm going to run my program. Yeah, this is the PL4. See, we are getting PL SQL procedure successfully completed, but we are not getting the output. Set server output on, because user get change in the meantime. See, what we are getting? We are getting a Scott. We are getting a Scott. Why we are getting a Scott? Because in your program, you are writing select enum into nm from emp where imply num is equal to 7788. For the imply number 7788, we are having the imply name Scott is there. 7788. What is the name? It's Scott is there. That's why we are getting a Scott. Suppose we are also looking for the salary. So I'm going to declare the variable x is of type number of 4. I am writing select enum comma sal into nm comma x. And now I'm going to display this. I'm going to display this x. Run this. So we are getting the name and we are getting the salary. Suppose I'm also looking for the job. So again, I need to declare the variable y is of type varchar2 of 20. Now I am writing select enum comma cell comma job into nm comma x comma y. Now we are writing going to display like nm x concatenated with y. Run this. Yeah, we are getting the name, we are getting the salary, and we are getting the job. So this is how we can apply the select statement in PLSQL. Suppose I'm just going to remove this line, like where imply number. I'm just going to remove this. Try to run this. See what message we are getting. Read the message. We are getting the message exact fetch return more than a requested number of rows. I just mentioned earlier that in the PLSQL, the select statement cannot return more than one row because you are not giving any where condition. So it's going to return the more than one row. That's why we are getting the error. So always we need to put some where condition. That we need to remember. So this is how we can apply the where select statement within the PLSQL. I'm just going to run like PL5.sql. Now, we are having the concept of percentage type attribute. What exactly the percentage type attribute is? If we want to declare the variable according to column definition. If we want to declare the variable according to column definition, we will use the percentage type attribute. Like, what I'm going to store in this particular variable, I'm going to store the name in this particular variable. In this variable, I'm going to store the salary. In this variable, I'm going to store the job. So in the place of nm is of type varchar2 of 20, x is of type number of 4, y is of type varchar2 of 20, I will go for nm is of type imp.enm percentage type. That's it. So you are going to declare the variable nm is of type imp.enm percentage type. Here I'm going to use x is of type imp.cell percentage type, or its job. Yeah, it's cell is there, cell percentage of type. Again, I'm going to use y job type, imp dot job percentage type. So this is what exactly the percentage type attribute is. We don't need to declare the variables like varchar2 or number. We don't need to do that. What I need to do, we just need to use table name dot column name percentage type. So the data type and the size of that particular variable will be the same as the size of the column and data types of the column. So this is how we can use this. This is what, this is your percentage type attribute. If you want to declare the variables according to the column definition. I'm going to run this. Yeah, it's working fine. We are getting the output like this. So this is what exactly we are having, percentage type attribute. PL6.SQL. Other than the percentage type, we are having the concept of percentage row type. Percentage row type. It's going to store the entire row, entire values. If we want to declare the variable according to the row definition. Row definition means what? I'm going to use NMEJ of type in percentage row type. Now this NM will store each and every values from that particular table. Like I'm going to use select star into NM. I'm going to use select star into NM. So each and every value from the EMP table will get stored into the NM. From EMP, where employee number is equal to 7788. Now, what I need to do, I need to display the name, nm.ename. I need to display the salary, nm.sal. I need to display the job, nm.job. So this is how we can do this. So we don't need to declare the variables again and again. What we can do, we can just declare the variable of EMP percentage row type. And if I'm going to use percentage row type, we need to apply the star, like select star into NM from EMP, where implied number is equal to 7788. And now we are getting these values. Run this. And we are getting the output. So this is how we can use the PL SQL program. This was the first program over there. This was the first program, how to write the PL SQL code. The first thing that we need to do always before writing the PL SQL code is set server output on. If I'm not going to do this, we will never get the output. So this is the first line we need to write. After that, you can write the program and get the output and all. The second program was it was related with the basic, like how to put the user input. For the user input, what we can do, we can use ampersand. This is what? This is the concatenation operator. Like in Java and all, normally we use the plus operator to concatenate. Here we use double filter. It's a concatenation operator. In the next program, it was how to use the if, how to use the for loop, how to use the while, how to use the case, how to use the loop and loop. So these programs are there. In the fourth one, how to use the select statement. How to use the select statement in PL SQL. This is how we can use that. Always we need to remember that select statement can't return more than one row. And that's why we are giving the condition. I need to put the condition so that it should return maximum one row. The next program was how to use the percentage type attribute. Percentage type attribute, if you want to declare the variable according to the column definition, like this. The next was how to use the percentage row type. Percentage row type attribute, if you want to declare the variable according to the row definition. This is how we can do that. NM is of type in percentage row type. We are writing select star into NM. From EMP, your imply number like this. So this is percentage type, percentage row type. So this was the program with the PL SQL. Are you comfortable with this? Now we can move with the next, or you need to do the practice?
To do the practice.
Okay. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to send you the mail, and you just need to go through this. And after that, we will start with the next.